Welcome to the Magnus Arena on the campus of the University of Denver. We're here for the Holiday Festival on Ice. Hello, everybody. I'm Tracy Wilson, along with Peter Carruthers. Tonight, a group of the world's finest skaters, led by Christy Yamaguchi. Joining Christy Yamaguchi, world champion Todd Eldridge, Olympic silver medalist Rosalind Sumners.
And there are the three-time U.S. pair skating champions and world silver medalists, Jenny Mino and Todd Sand, along with Angela Nikodinov, the 1999 U.S. bronze medalist in ladies' figure skating.
The veteran and the newcomers. There's Brian Orser, two-time Olympic silver medalist, and the brother and sister team, Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler, fourth at U.S. Nationals in pairs.
The beautiful ice dancing team of Renee Rocha and Gorsha Sir, two-time U.S. ice dancing champions, and Mr. Charisma himself, Kurt Browning, four-time world champion.
A trio of crowd favorites. Canadian and world pair champions Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler, and eight-time British champion Stephen Cousins.
Sure does.
I remember when I used to compete. The one day I didn't go on the ice was at Christmas. All of the arenas would be closed, and it was a day to spend with my family and friends, a day of relative calm right in the middle of a busy competitive season.
Absolutely. I remember growing up in Massachusetts, skating in my backyard with the snow coming down, my sister alongside, and the holidays upon us. Truly a great memory. But then competition snuck into our skating. Sometimes we'd have good competitions and other times not so good. But whenever we'd get home for the holidays, it was a great time to remember why we started skating. Skating gave us so much joy and pleasure. And that was a time of the year when you could give thanks over doing something that you love to do so much. And that, of course, was skating.
Welcome back to the Holiday Festival on Ice. Within the walls of the Williams Tower on the University of Denver campus ring the 65 bronze bells of the Williams Carillon. It is appropriate during this holiday season that these bells ring out each night to remind all of us this special time of the year. When we come back, we'll watch Olympic champion Christy Yamaguchi. Welcome back to the University of Denver, where visions of sugar plums are in the air. At the 1984 Winter Olympics, Rosalind Sumners won the silver medal. For Roz, those Olympic memories will always be with her, especially the Christmas of 83, just before Sarajevo.
In 83, of course, right before the Olympics, I think my brain was just, I was already getting fried. I was at that point of the nerves and the stress and just the pressure of knowing the Olympics was around the corner. So I really...
More from Denver when we return. Since the beginning of the 1999 school year, the Armentarius Quartet has been together. These four students are from Denver's Lamont School of Music. Their selection now, the traditional English carol, The Holly and the Ivy. Roca and Gorcia Sir have been skating together since 1990. Their union was unusual. She is an American citizen, and he was a citizen of the former Soviet Union. When Gorcia defected to the States in 1990, his journey was far from over. Both of them now live in San Francisco. If you want to find Gorcia on a free weekend, your best chance of spotting him is at a local Russian deli. He looks the part of a food connoisseur, examining the exotic tastes from Russia. Don't be fooled. Gorcia's taste in food has improved considerably since those first lonely days in a strange land.
I'm gonna take some red caviar. Hey, it's a bargain really here.
When I first moved here, I didn't really have problems with shopping or finding my directions or anything, but I had problems with cooking because first time I lived by myself, you know, so I lived for about a year. I lived on hot dogs and scrambled eggs.
I remember when I first went to skate with him, I opened up his refrigerator and there was half a pack of hot dogs and some Easter Bunny chocolate or something there that was old, and I just thought, we've got to get you to the grocery store and teach you how to cook some things more than, you know, hot dogs and eggs.
Gorcia is now an American citizen, and together with Renee, they have won two U.S. championships and one pro championship in ice dance. Their professional relationship is just that. Work hard together in practice and go their own ways. Nevertheless, Renee knows this complex man better than anyone else. His journey to a different culture has been filled with pitfalls, and yet, he succeeded on his terms.
Gorcia came here, he knew what he wanted, and I think he knew where he wanted to be. I mean, he was smart enough and together enough that he learned to acclimate himself. He did what he needed to do. He found a job, he started working, and, you know, he pulled his life together here without much help. He did it himself.
I assimilated to living in America so fast and so well because I didn't really have a language barrier. I think because I started speaking English when I was in school so young, you know, I was not afraid of communicating with people and kind of learning their way of living and what they have to say. So I wasn't afraid to speak to them and to communicate.
Whether it is in pair skating or ice dance, personality differences will always arise. Renee and Gorcia are no different. Their desire for perfection can cause some strain on the relationship and provide some humor.
I guess I have to get to use, well, I got used to your attitude very fast. That's something European women don't have generally as much as in America. So I had to learn real quick, you know.
It's called independence.
Вежливость, да? Хорошо.
You have to.
It is kind of hard.
You have to try and pick me up before I can turn out. But we work okay together. Just sometimes that, you know, that mood thing happens. The Russian drama.
We're having a hard time agreeing where to go for lunch sometimes.
I don't know what the step is.
No, in Russia, you have to carry your partner's bag. I mean, she wouldn't touch the luggage, she wouldn't touch your skates, nothing. So it was up to actually the guy to do it. Open the door, you know, stuff like that. Bring flowers to the rink every day.
You're holding it up.
Carrying her bag went for about a year. Well, in Russia, you had to...
A year? Oh, excuse me. Oh, no.
Well, you see, when I'm trying to hold your knee up, See what's happening?
But you have to let me around the back of you.
I'll get there.
Actually, it's not too much of a challenge because at this point, we have generally the same taste and same ideas and things, fortunately. But I'll tell you, there are some days, well, I've learned all the bad words in Russian already. Let's put it that way. I know them all.
Welcome back to the Ritchie Center on the University of Denver campus. I'm Tracy Wilson along with Peter Carruthers at the Holiday Festival on Ice. Here is Todd Fair bringing you the sounds of the holiday.
A very clean performance by Stephen Cousins, and for that clean performance, he deserves this recognition from Caress.
When we return to Denver, the U.S. pair champions, Jenny Mino and Todd Sand. Welcome back to the Holiday Festival on Ice. We rejoin the Armentarius Quartet and their rendition of the French carol Angels We Have Heard on High. Now for the Aflac trivia question. Peter Carruthers, you should get this. The number of U.S. pair teams who won medals at the Winter Olympics.
Tracy, I'm lousy at trivia, but I'm going to go with five teams on this.
Is that your final answer?
I'll tell you when the answer comes.
We're back in Denver for the Holiday Festival on Ice. I'm Tracy Wilson, along with Peter Carruthers, and TBS Superstation is proud to present this Christmas special. It's time now for the answer to our Aflac trivia question, Peter. How many Olympic U.S. pair teams have won medals? You said five. Let's see.
Yes! At least I can count.
Peter, the silver medal that you won with your sister Kitty in 84 counts as one of those five medals won. Special visit now. Here comes Santa.
Is that you, Santa Claus?
Gifts I'm preparing for some Christmas sharing, but I pause because hang in my stocking, I can hear it knocking. Is that you, Santa Claus? Sure is dark out, ain't the slightest spark out on my clacking jaw. Who's there, who is it? Stopping for a visit? Is that you, Santa Claus? Are you bringing a present for me? Something pleasant for me. That is just what I've been waiting for. Would you mind slipping it under the door? Old winds are howling, up for that big growling. My legs feel like stars. Yeah, my, oh me, my. Kindly will you reply? Is that you, Santa Claus?
Christmas magic from Brian Orser, Todd Eldridge, Kurt Browning, and Stephen Cousins.
Yes, hanging in stockings, I can hear knocking. Is that you, Santa Claus? Stop for a visit. Is that you, Santa Claus? Oh, that Santa, you gave me a scare. Now stop teasing, cause I know you're there. We don't believe in no goblins today, but I can't can't explain why I'm shaking that way. But I can see old Santa in the keyhole. I'll get to the cause. One peek and I'll try there. Oh, there's an eye there. Is that you, Santa Claus? Please, please, paint him on me. Say that's you, Santa Claus.
Orser, Browning, Eldridge, and Cousins. What they really would like for Christmas is that triple axle.
Hang in my stocking, I can hear a knocking. Is that you, Santa Claus?
Oh, here they come. Santa, Santa, can we get a word with the Santa Clauses in a row here? Beautiful. Now.
Holy sow cow.
My question, holy sow cow, beautiful. My question is, who is the most generous Santa in this line right now?
The fattest. You.
Him.
Him. Where's it me?
He's bad.
Yeah, we're all fat.
No, me.
I don't know.
Okay, let's try another question. I want the real Santa to take one step forward when I count to three. Wait. Let's see who the real Santa is. Ready? One, two, three. I guess we'll never know this one.
All right, I got things to do. The wife is waiting.
Well,
I want a triple axle for Christmas. You know,
I got a mince pie to eat.
I don't know. Well.
I want a triple Santa.
Bye, Santas. Thank you. Be good to the children.
When we come back, I'll have a conversation with Christy Yamaguchi. I'm Tracy Wilson, along with Peter Carruthers, welcoming you back to the University of Denver and the Armentarius Quartet. They are now playing the traditional French carol, Bring Your Torch, Jeanette Isabella. Along with Peggy Fleming and Dorothy Hamill, Christy Yamaguchi is considered one of America's female skating icons. We have seen her grow before our very eyes into a mature person on and off the ice. And soon she will embark on another chapter in her life, a summer bride.
Christy, what's your favorite Christmas memory?
Well, I'd have to say last Christmas was pretty special. My fiance and I got engaged Christmas Eve, so it was a bit of a surprise, but a good one.
Were you outside? Were you in the snow under Christmas lights, or?
Actually, we were in San Francisco, and he had just flown in that morning or that evening, and we went to dinner with my sister and brother-in-law, and then later on went and went to this place that had a really nice view of San Francisco, and that's where he proposed.
Now, Brett Hedekin is your fiance, and he's plays for the NHL, Florida Panthers. You're on a 70-city tour. How do you manage to get together for Christmas?
It's tough. I mean, he'll have maybe 2 or 3 days off. I'll have about the same. So we'll try to manage. The last 3 years, he's come to San Francisco, played the Sharks the day after. This year, I think we're going to try to make a trip to Minnesota, where it's his hometown and his family, and visit there and then get on with the tour.
Have you been away from your family at Christmas before?
This will actually be my first year in 28 years away from my family and parents, and you know, it'll be hard, but I think it's also a sign of a new generation starting as well.
You might even be able to get out and skate with them.
We'll see. Yes, I mean, I hear there are a lot of great skating parties in Minnesota Christmas time, so I'll have to bundle up, though.
Right now, you're busy also, as well as skating, planning your wedding. When are you getting married?
Right now, we have July 8th as our date. And so a lot of planning now. We're trying to do that before we both get too busy into our seasons. But it's been a lot of fun so far.
You're not planning to get married on the ice in an arena?
No ice. We're going to get as far away from ice as possible and probably hit somewhere warm.
Still to come, world champion Todd Eldridge.
Browning is a skater who definitely brings his personality onto the ice. Yet somewhere out there, does the perfect program exist?
There are many perfect programs waiting to be skated. Sometimes halfway through a 60-city tour in East Lansing, you skate the perfect program. And it might have been because you found out your friend's not going to die of cancer that day. I think the perfect program is waiting, and it might be the last one I ever do for my six-year-old child. I don't know what it'll be, but there's lots of perfect programs left out there.
We're back at the University of Denver, and here's a final look at the Armentarius Quartet playing an English carol, Greensleeves. We're back at the University of Denver for a final look at the cast of Holiday Festival on Ice.
Heaviness, all the heaviness. side. So as he flew back over the land, a gift for his Lord was there in his hand.
From our family to yours, we wish you all a happy holiday season.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. Folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe really helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.